my top five stretches for spondylitis, AS. Come to standing in front of a chair with the forefeet in a non-slip position. Feet hip width apart, feet parallel. Raise the right leg, have the left leg vertical to the floor, hands to the hips, breathe in. Bend forwards from the hips. Soften the right knee, that means bend the right knee. This brings the stretch away from a strain behind the knee into a stretch into the upper hamstrings and the glutes here. Move on the out breath. And hip the right hip backwards. Practice that one. We always do the other side to correct any misalignment that's happened from years of having AS. Hands to hips. On the out breath, bend forwards. Soften the left knee. Keep the right leg vertical to the floor. Hands to the thigh or to the shin, not to the knee. Keep a soft bend in the left knee. Head in line with the spine. Feel the stretch in the left hamstrings and the glutes there. Lift the head to come out of the pose. Shake out. Now to what's called in English the pyramid pose. In Sanskrit, the ancient language of yoga, Parsvottanasana. Stand with feet hip width apart. Take the right leg forwards just underneath the chair and the left foot back. So that you're now, the feet are a leg length apart, but you've kept the distance between the feet. The pelvis is now pointing out to the left, breathing in. Take the right hip backwards so that these front points of the pelvis are in line with the front of the chair. And if that feels good, then you can stretch forwards from the hips again. You can take the hands to the chair to give you a bit of support. Don't take too much weight onto the hands and hit the right hip backwards. Keep a soft bend in both knees and breathe. Keep breathing. When we say hold, we don't mean stay still. We mean keep breathing and keep working in the pose. Always do the other side. Step forwards, foot under. Take your chair for some support. Take the right toes back. The toes are now pointing out to 10 o'clock. And these two points of the pelvis are now pointing out to the right. So this was always my favorite pose. Breathing in. Take the right hip forwards and the left hip back. Soften both knees. Breathe in. On the out breath, you can bend forwards. Take the hands to the chair, fingertips or the palms, whichever's most comfortable for you. Always try to be comfortable and steady in a yoga pose. Hit the left hip back and feel that stretch. Keep breathing. Keep breathing in your own natural rhythm. Always come out of a pose slowly. You've done more work than you think you have, and come to standing. You can shake out again. And now the sitting forward bend. What we're doing here is decompressing the spine. Come to sitting on the front edge of your chair. And sit as tall as you comfortably can. Take the feet hip width apart, feet are parallel again. Rest the palms of the hand on the chair. Relax the shoulders down. Breathing in, on the out breath, lean forwards again from the hips and fold over, taking the crown of the head in the direction of the floor. Rest the hands on the fronts of the thighs, like so. You can have a stool in front of you, or if you're supple, you can take the hands to the floor. But keep the back of the buttocks here firmly on the chair. Try not to roll too far forwards. We want the lengthening of the spine. Tuck the chin to the chest. And relax into it. You may feel you can bring the toes a little bit further forwards. And to come out of the pose, breathe in and lift the head, and very slowly, using the hands to help you, come forwards. The ancient yoga name for that pose is Uttanasana, the standing forward bend. Now, another way that you can do this is by leaning against the wall. So you take the fingertips to the wall, the feet are well away from the wall, bend the knees and take the buttocks to the wall. So you've got a nice strong foundation now. Breathing in, fold forwards. So this sternum bone here is going forwards and up initially. And then the belly is coming first of all in contact with the thighs. So you've got a very considerable bend in the knees. And then just dangle so that the weight of the head, the arms and the shoulders are helping you to lengthen the spine, to increase the gap between the vertebrae. And this will help with your mobility and range of motion, range of movements in your spine. Take the chin to the chest and look behind you between the legs. This is one of those poses that, if you're comfortable, stay for 30 seconds. And to come out of the pose, take the fingertips back to the wall, push yourself nice and slowly away, and I suggest, first of all, you lift the head and scoop up to reinforce the natural S shape of your spine. Fourth pose. Another favourite, it's called tabletop. Have a chair with the back facing you and take the heels of the hands here to the top of the chair at shoulder distance apart. So the arms are going straight forwards, not out to the side or into the middle. Fingers are positive and walk back, walk the feet backwards. Bring a soft bend into the knees and this helps you to just flatten the spine. Now, you may be here. You may be here, you may be here, but keep that soft bend in the knees and keep stretching backwards so that you can feel an opening in the ribs, in the armpits. And keep breathing, keep the ears between the upper arms. And keep breathing in the pose. Tilt the pelvis so that the buttocks are pointing up towards the ceiling a little bit. Try not to dip the spine too much in the middle. Keep a flat back. And to come out of the pose, just after you've practiced that for about 30 seconds, just come forward and shake out. Shake out the arms. Shake out the legs as well. Now, a variation that we can do on this to accentuate, take the heels of the hands to the top of the chair again. Walk backwards, put a soft bend in the knees. That's what I mean by a soft bend, but not much. Breathing in, take the right hip back. So you're making a kind of a banana shape with the right hand side of your body. Right from the fingertips of the right hand, through the right arm, the right shoulder, the right ribs, down to the right hip. And that's a very nice stretch. None of this should be uncomfortable or a strain. Stretch, not strain. Come back to the center. Breathing in. On the out-breath, stretch the left hip back. so that you've now got the banana shape on the left hand side of your body, from the left fingertips through the left arm, the left shoulder, the left ribs, down to the left hip. And this is pretty safe to practice, to hold, so long as you keep breathing. A hold is not stopping breathing. And breathe in your own way, your own comfortable rhythm, your own speed. And to come out of the pose, bend the knees slightly and walk forwards. And now lastly, a lying down pose, reclining pose. And you can use any sort of cushion or book. I've got two yoga blocks here. One is 2.5 centimeters thick and the other one is 5 centimeters thick. Let's start with the 2.5, and the idea of this is that we're using the gentle force of gravity to help us keep the natural S shape in the spine. And the top of whatever you're lying across, whether it's a book or a cushion or a yoga block or anything really, the top edge is just below the shoulder blades. Come back to your lying on your elbows. And you'll want to raise the knees, have a little wriggle around to get comfortable. The arms are straight away from the body and the palms are face up. You can take hold of the head and just lift the scalp so that the chin comes to the chest. So you also get a stretch in the back of the neck, a lengthening in the back of the neck. Breathing in, roll the shoulders out. This raises the chest to the chin. The chin is already down to the chest, and maintain that by looking down the body past the tip of the nose and look towards a wall rather than the ceiling. If you look to the ceiling, you run the risk of arching the back of the neck and losing that stretch there. Knees are raised for comfort. You can have a 5 centimeter yoga block or cushion. This is 2.5, which is plenty to start off with. And we're going to rest here. So keep breathing, keep rolling the shoulders out, lifting the chest, opening the chest, getting a little bit more air into the system. The breath in yoga is prana, the life force. Allow the belly button to withdraw down towards the inner spine. And if you wish to accentuate this pose, you can straighten the legs. Now, if that feels like too much, whenever we accentuate a pose, if it feels like too much, back off and ease off. Go back to your starting position, like so. But if that feels good and you're comfortable and it feels like a good stretch, then straighten the legs and just lift there. Relax the eyes. And keep looking down past the tip of the nose towards a wall. And you can stay here for 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 90 seconds, 2 minutes. The longer that you hold or you stay in a pose, maybe you can reach into some of those deeper soft tissues and give them a good stretch as well. But the key thing is to be comfortable, to be safe, and to enjoy it. To come out of this pose, bring the knees back up and roll nice and slowly. No rush, no hurry, to one side. Place the palms of both hands on the floor and come to a comfortable sitting position. You can sit on your block or your book. And if you're going across the legs, make sure you're comfortable. And you can do that by moving the cross of the feet a little further away from the body. My favorite top 5 stretches for AS. Enjoy.
You can follow up from this class with a free live online class with other people with AS. Plus, watch all the recordings of the classes on catch up. Plus, a 14-day free trial to our Yoga for AS virtual library of over 20 pre-recorded courses, which is more than 200 hours of yoga modified for AS. You'll be taken directly to the live classes and the virtual library by following the links in the description below this video. Or you can go straight to our website, yogaforas.com, and follow the links from there.